Laban, you know, tomorrow they are holding a graduation. It is his second graduation since he was appointed the vice chancellor of course, acting. He'll be confirmed later or soon. We hope so.
Okay.
You know, this is a special coverage. He's going to talk about quite a bit of himself, about tomorrow's graduation, of course, something else, maybe something you don't know. So welcome, Professor.
Thank you very much.
Of course, the first thing is to congratulate you on the UAM. We understand that your term has been extended.
Yes.
For yet another 3 or so months.
Yes.
And of course, they're going to extend it even much more.
Hopefully.
5 years or even 10.
No idea. Okay, yes.
Now, let's begin. Tomorrow we're holding a graduation. Of course, it is your second.
Yeah.
What expectations are we? What are we expecting tomorrow?
Well, graduations are very special. Graduations mark a very significant milestone in anybody's life. And for us at Moi University, this is the 33rd graduation. And we are graduating 4,380 students from our 15 schools. And what do we expect? We expect a very colorful ceremony. We expect a lot of happiness from our graduates and the parents, and of course faculty, having seen us mold these students, the undergraduates or even the postgraduate students, to become what God had intended them to become. So we are all very, very, very excited about tomorrow.
We'll come back to that graduation. Now, let's go to a different question.
Yeah.
Actually, Moi University for the past 3 or 5 months, the previous times, this institution has been on the spotlight for not good reasons. Mm-hmm. Have that picture changed?
I think so. I first of all, like any other institution, you go through, you know, good times and bad times. And we have had our share of bad times, bad publicity, lack of development, and just lack of confidence of the Kenyan populace in the university. But I think the last three months or so, if nothing else, the spirit is different. I see the students are happier. I see the staff more determined, faculty and non-teaching staff whom people had condemned as not to want to work have cleaned up Moi University. It's clean and everybody's running to work. And for me, that's a big step. And we are hoping that in the coming 3 months again, people begin to see constructions, physical development of the university. So we are looking up, yeah.
We can see, of course, some changes. Of course, physical change. Of course, there is the other bit of mental change, the attitude of the workers, of the staff. Are they changing?
Yeah, I think so. One of the most difficult things in management is touching the heart of people. Change must be internally driven. And the only way I'm going to make you go where I want to go is for me to show you my commitment. So change is usually best achieved when it is experiential. If the staff here see the vice chancellor in the office at 6:15 every morning, they'll find it very hard to come at night. And so I don't even have to write a circular. Anytime I have an opportunity, I keep telling them that we need to work harder to make our university better. We create wealth, then we shall benefit. So I think the spirit, the mentality is changing. But it is hard to reconfigure the value system of an organization. And that's what we're trying to do.
Yeah. Are you facing some? Of course, in any organization, there's change. When change comes, of course, there's some resistance. Are you facing some resistance?
Well, I think resistance is positive. I haven't seen measurable resistance, but I know people are grumbling about the pressure to perform. I am dead serious about these missing marks. I will not have it in this university. I'm dead serious about all of us, me included, going to class, and I do go to class. I'm dead serious about cleanliness, and we are dead serious about financial management. In fact, that's where I've put a lot of my energies. And today, I'm happy that I'm not worried about December salaries like in the past. I'm not worried about paying PSSP to the schools. I'm going to pay, release a check of 100 million to the schools so that the service providers, the lecturers, get their money.
Yeah.
Our compulsory deductions to pension, to insurance, to bank loans, we are meeting a bit of the bargain. And so I think the financial management under Professor Terus and myself is heading in the right direction.
It's coming up well.
Yeah.
Now, the university is set to hold another graduation tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Now, for you, what could be the Kenyan University of the future?
Mm. Actually, I don't want to preempt what I want to say tomorrow, but I'm going to make a very passionate appeal about the rebranding of Moi University. And the rebranding of Moi University is a very personal endeavor on anybody in Moi, whether you are a cleaner, a professor, or a student. It's very personal. And so I'm going to ask for a character change. We must learn to be people who can be trusted and people who genuinely want to see Moi better. Once I can get that in people, I think, give us, if I was allowed to be here for 2-3 years, this place will never be the same again. I am so clear in my mind where we want to go. So we are using this graduation as a way of re-announcing ourselves. And now we have stopped crying about our problems. We are now positive. You know, the child died, we buried. And now we've got to look ahead.
Yeah.
So we are looking ahead, and we just want to give everybody the confidence that they can do it. And even me, when the university sends me in quotes to Treasury or the Ministry, they are sure that our VC will do his best to get some resources for the university. When you people pay your money, you are sure that that money is safe. When you pay your money for trips, you are sure that it will be safe for you to go for teaching practice in January. So that's what we are trying to do. Yeah.
Now, is it the reason why they call you Magufuli? You know they call you Magufuli?
I didn't know.
You don't know that?
I didn't know
that. Of course they do.
I'm not a socialist.
And you're the father of everyone here.
Yes.
When there's a problem, the students cry.
Yeah.
They say a hero. They don't know anybody else.
Yeah.
The staff, they say it's a hero.
Yeah.
The previous times there was mud all over.
Yeah.
And even I discovered there's a lot of water in the university because sometimes I find people washing, like, where is this water coming from?
Yeah. Ah, Magufuli, that is radical. But in a way, if I can transform Moi, in other words, by the way, greatness is measured by service to mankind. And me, I don't want to be famous. I don't want to be famous. I want to be seen to be a great person who helped transform. Because being famous is quite a trip. But I just want to be great in terms of service to humanity. And there's something about me and Moi that people don't understand.
Yeah.
I was a headmaster of a school in Western Province. And the school did very well. And the retired president, you know, picked me from that school to go and start Sunshine.
Yes.
It was unbelievable because I was just a headmaster of a secondary school in Western, Lubino Boys. And then because it had performed from position 2000 to position 56,
oh, wow,
in the 2 years I'd been there, the president said, "Who is that?" And I was lifted to go and start Sunshine. Now that was the turning point in my life. Working for a president of the Republic of Kenya, giving me the first form once, and in 4 years we were in the top 10 in the country. So I have, it's very clear for me that anything Moi, my loyalty is unquestionable. And that's what people don't understand. What drives me to make Moi better is because I know the founding father had a vision of making this university one of the best. And so I want to carry that vision because he made me. And I wouldn't be a professor, I would be now somebody retired in the village at home. But that aside, I think this country needs transformative leadership so that we can overcome the encumbrances of ethnicity and mediocrity and be able to move our country forward. Yeah, thank you.
In your term, would you invite the retired President Moi?
Oh yeah, definitely. I'm praying for him. I keep praying for him. Nobody is perfect. Yeah. He might not have done great things, but I think he touched many souls through education. And I'm just hoping that we can start the amphitheater. I'm hoping that Treasury will give us money.
The one in front here?
Yeah. Okay. We want to start a 6,000 capacity, sitting capacity. And I want to name it after him, although this is Moi University, but that one will be Daniel Toroitich Arap Moi Amphitheater.
That will be amazing.
Yes, and just call him to lay the foundation stone.
When
can you once I get the funds from Treasury, they have committed, but we have not yet gotten the funds, so we're waiting.
Okay.
But for me, yes.
That is very nice. Now, for some time, the word Renaissance, of course, you're a scholar, has been popular in scholarship in the continent, in the whole of Africa. Are there specific ways of enhancing this way of thinking and to cause it to bear fruit in Africa, in Kenya?
Yes, and you know, I don't know how to put it. Renaissance is an inner urge to change your situation. A very deep urge. Almost a selfless urge to want to change your situation. And I'm beginning to see that in Africa. When you start seeing peaceful transitions after elections like in Ghana, when you begin to see leaders, even like our president, Uhuru Kenyatta, with some very ambitious projects, if you look at the bigger picture, like the computers for schools, you know, it's not a political idea. That's a huge global thinking idea that he has this desire to see the Kenyan child in primary school get into the digital world. That is where the urge for change will be triggered in. And so the Renaissance involves scratching our conscience. Like you come to Moi and you drive into Moi and you look at the front of Moi University and it doesn't look like a university. You know, there's that huge crevasse, unkept. And then you have an urge and say, but surely we can be better.
Yeah, of course.
You go to Kenyatta University and you see in the last 10 years, I'm an alumni of that university, in the last 10 years, what has happened? And then you begin to say, but Moi, we can also be. We can be, by the way, for us it will not be 10 years. Given a chance in this university, it will be 5 years, and people will never know that this is the same Moi University.
It will be different. Now, coming back to Moi University, what would you say is unique dynamic, which if strengthened could produce great students, great minds?
I think our environment is just amazing. If we could improve on the ambience and our physical location, gives us a huge advantage. Do you know what my dream is? My dream is that I can pull the School of Medicine from town to here. I can pull the School of Law from annex and we convert that annex into investment for the university and bring all this here and make a city, a campus. Because Eldoret is growing. Soon people will feel...
People are coming to Annex.
Yeah, it's crowded. Yeah. So, if we had... I've gone to campuses in the US. I mean, I teach at Texas A&M. I teach at Witwatersrand in South Africa. And the idea of a campus, this suits it. All we need is infrastructure and make our students believe in themselves. And I've seen great potential in the students here. You know, amazing. After all, we get the best among the best students in the country.
Yeah.
In all our schools, we take the cream, being the second public university.
Yeah. Now, you are an educationist. Of course, you've been this for a while, for a long time. In a researcher, of course, you are leading a World Bank research.
Yeah.
I know it. And now, looking at the Kenyan child and the new proposed curriculum, of course, you've been part of this.
I am.
Now, do you see any implied changes at the university level? Are you going to have any changes?
Oh, yeah, definitely. In fact, being an expert on the curriculum reform for the country, we are saying that these reforms are not about basic education. Because the graduate of that system we are creating is going to enter our university. And that graduate will not fit into the conservative classroom, lecture hall, theater that we have today. So universities would be urged, would be compelled to engage in the 21st century learning applications, where you are bringing in technology, you are bringing in critical thinking, you are bringing in social skills, you are bringing in emotional intelligence, and you are making students take charge of their learning. That's what we would like to see the universities. And they must prepare for it, because those are the students that are coming.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes. Now, research and growing of a profession go hand in hand. Mm-hmm. Now, do you think this mix is enough attention in Africa and in Kenya?
Mm-hmm.
Is it given enough attention?
No. You know, good countries, good in terms of economic development, the US, Japan, and Malaysia, and the other ones, they are spending about 10% of their GDP on research. We are spending about 0.02% on research as a country.
Yeah.
The real monies that go to research. So, one of the things some of us would like to influence the government is to invest in research. And investing in research means investing in universities. Home here, the role of a dean in Moi University is going to change drastically come 2017. Because a dean will not just be in charge of teaching and learning. They must have a research portfolio engaging students. You mentioned the World Bank. I'm going to use about 60 of you in the research, because I want you to imbibe the skills of research. I want you to create an appetite, because that is where you make a difference. And more still, that's where you make the money. Money is not made in just teaching in the classroom. Yeah.
You have to work. Now, as you release them, university graduates, tomorrow, to their future and to serve in the professional areas, now, is there a specific ethic that you'd like them to cultivate out there?
Oh, yeah. My message, and this is not my message. There is Maya Angelou. She's a poet. She passed on 2 years ago.
Yeah.
She has influenced my life immensely. I've read about 47 of her works. I watch her videos. And there's one that has transformed my life in the last 5 years. And that is, her message is very clear. Just do what is right. And that's my message tomorrow to my graduates. As you go out there, do what is right and surrender the rest to God. And you'll be surprised how far you will go in life. So if you are becoming a teacher, a doctor, a banker, you know, a journalist, just do what is right. You'll get so much satisfaction, you'll get so much protection, you'll have so much enthusiasm and energy to move. You know, I wake up 4 o'clock every morning, sometimes 3 o'clock to do some reading of my own. And what drives me to be in Moi at 6 o'clock in the morning is because I want to do what is right. I want to reconfigure Moi University. I've seen us, you know, really, really go down and become the laughing stock of other universities. So I want to do what is right. I want to see things change in Moi. And that is the biggest satisfaction. And when you do that, by the way, you don't need a politician to move you to the next level.
Yeah.
No, you don't need to look for money in corrupt ways. You will earn a decent salary. You'll prosper in your own right. Yeah. So the biggest message is do what is right. And that relates to character development.
Yeah. Now, just mention that you come here, you report to work at 6, which is quite rare with the previous people. Now, do you ever find time to do your own personal business? You also here on Saturday, sometimes on Sunday.
I do.
Just around. Do you?
Yeah, no, I must admit it's been very tough. But that's me. If you ask my students in Sunshine, Nairobi, they'll tell you that's him. A workaholic, and he wants to do things for other people. But I thank God, as I look back at my family, they've been supportive. God has seen me, you know, get 2 lawyers in my family, a medical doctor, an engineer, 2 teachers. I mean, and through public schools, I didn't pay any. They didn't go through any private schools. Those are blessings when you give to others. So yes, a lot of my own things are not moving, but I think for this period, God intends me to do something different at Moi University.
Now, could you? As a person, could you be the person that this institution was waiting for many years ago?
I don't know. You know that there's a word in English called serendipity. Serendipity is the fortune of encountering good luck. This is just luck. By the way, I'm in that office just by luck.
Mentioning luck.
Yeah.
You came here, you were a director,
yeah,
quality assurance.
Yes.
And then you... all of a sudden things changed. Yeah. You happen to be the DVC acting for a few days.
About
then
15
you,
days.
Then
yeah.
Here you are.
Yeah. So call it serendipity, call it a call from heaven, and that's it. So every time I ask myself, what did God really want? I didn't apply. I'm not exceptional. I never even ever thought. The only job I applied for here was DVC academic, and I wasn't shortlisted.
But you got it?
No, I wasn't shortlisted. I didn't get the job. I didn't go for the interview. And then I went on with my quality assurance work. So, perhaps it's God.
Are you surprised that you're going this far?
Overwhelmed. Really, this undertaking is far beyond my talents. And that's why I'm submitting to everybody and saying, I can't do it alone. We have to do it together. And my biggest constituency are the students. That's why you see me everywhere. You see me in the exam rooms to see how they're doing exams. I've seen the crowding in the exams, and it has pained me. That's why I want lecture halls. I go to the hostels. I see the broken sinks and the non-flushing toilets, and I get depressed. I see the kind of life our students are leading. I go to our library and I see the scarcity of computers today. A library is about ICT. So all those things make me want to work harder, because if I can get students to be fully engaged and enjoy the university life, really enjoy and exploit their potential to the maximum, I think I'll have played my part.
Yeah. Now, given, suppose you're given a contract, 5 years contract,
mm-hmm.
What would you do? What?
First of all, it can never be beyond 5 years.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't believe in renewal.
It can be 4.
And I wouldn't want to do this job for more than 5 years.
Yeah.
I have just the physics of it. You'd be an exhausted machine if you really have to work hard.
Yeah.
So it's, if I was allowed to, if the job was advertised and I did the interview and I got the job, it would be a one-term VC. But in that one term, I'll want to see the total transformation of Moi University. I don't know whether you've gone to the School of Law. We have had that library building stranded. But now the contractors, they're working.
Yeah,
right by now. March, by the coming 3 weeks, it will be roofed. By end of March, it will be complete with a backup generator and everything. You know, how wonderful. We are starting on floodlights. I'm signing off the letters today for the contractors to come to put strategic floodlights.
Yeah.
We are starting partial walling of the university. We want to rebrand the gate. And then if we get support from Treasury, we want to do the amphitheater, we want to do lecture halls. That's just a beginning. By the way, all that can be done in 2017.
Yes. So 2017, only 1 year.
Yeah, so now you look ahead. What will happen in the other 3-4 years? It's possible. And even now, I want to take this opportunity. Even now, the problem we have of casual workers and all that, I keep saying nobody would be laid off because we shall have so much work. Imagine if we put up an amphitheater of 6,000, we put up 4 lecture halls of 500. Already, how many people do you need to keep
those? You need a